Welcome to the Ryan Kavanaugh is running a Ponzi scheme podcast, accused by his ex-partner.
Yeah, he's not running a Ponzi scheme necessarily. He's been accused by his ex-partner of running a Ponzi
bingo
scheme in as reported in Variety.
Well, anyway, you guys know about that. But did you know there's a new nugget of information about Cav that is so crazy, so horrific, it will explain everything you need to know about this man.
That's hot.
Ryan Kavanaugh. Listen to this memo from Deadline. Now, Deadline, like Variety, Dan, and you can correct me because you're in the biz.
I'm in the biz. I'm a big shot producer, just like Ryan once was. Not anymore.
No, he's bankrupt.
Yeah, he's bankrupt now. He bankrupted his production studio. But yeah, no, Deadline's, along with Variety, Hollywood Reporter, Deadline. Those are like the three.
Well, it looks like their slogan is breaking Hollywood news since 2006, so.
All the way back in 2006.
It's not that established.
They've had a stellar rise, like Relativity Media once did.
Well, I mean,
but unlike Relativity, it's still in business.
Well, hold on. 2006 is pretty early for a website. Let's not poo-poo that. I mean,
ish, yeah.
So anyway, here. Listen to this, man. Listen to this headline. This is from 2018, not that long ago. Relativity fabricated memo claiming sexual harassment against former co-president Adam Fields. Judge awards $8.4 million. Okay, now wait till you read the freaking details of this. In short, there's this guy, Adam Fields, who was a president they brought on to Relativity to save his failing bankrupt production company. And when he decided he didn't want to pay him anymore, I'm paraphrasing the article, okay? The judge said, and I'll read her quote, or his quote, I don't know the gender, that Ryan Kavanaugh forged a document claiming he sexually harassed people so he could fire him without paying him severance. Is that, like, mental? Like, how? Like, whoa. Whoa.
Wow.
Forget, this is the Ryan Kavanaugh forged a document claiming his ex-president sexually assaulted people so to avoid paying him severance podcast now.
This is sick.
Here, I'm going to read all this. Oh, here's an update. Claims of sexual harassment from seven women at Relativity against former Relativity co-president Adam Fields have been found the result of a fraudulent memorandum devised, according to the arbitrating judge, Terry Friedman, by Relativity CEO Ryan Kavanaugh himself. Bruh. The validity of that memo, which claimed that more than a handful of women complained to HR have been subjected to sexual harassment by Fields, was also denied by the managing director of the company, an overseer of HR, Carol Jenis, who denied ever seeing or authoring that memo. So here's the thing. He brings in this document. First, this is so mental. He says, I'm going to fire this guy because he's sexually harassing people. You know what's weird is in the termination letter, it didn't say anything about the sexual harassment. And then he magically produces this letter that was apparently written by this HR person. And when the judge asked the HR person, did you sign this letter? She says, no, I've never heard of it. I don't know anything about what they're talking about.
Bruh.
Weird.
The validity of the yada, yada, yada. Here, the validity of the memo, which claimed that more than a handful in her testimony during a civil suit brought by Fields against Kavanaugh and Relativity, she stated that she never heard of any harassment claims and knew nothing of the memorandum. Here, this one, it gets great. A forensic audit of the computer was conducted, and it was found that the memo had been generated by someone who signed it as Cav.
Bruh.
Who could that be? It certainly points to this man. Wait, is it this man or this man? They look so similar. I think it's him.
No. No, I think
Ryan
it was
Kavanaugh?
I think it's the other guy.
Oh, that's
yeah,
Ryan Kavanaugh.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Cav.
That's Cav Cav.
If they had a band together, those two, it'd probably be called Cav Cav.
Mm. Cav Cav. Probably be called Essay. Oh, I mean, no. Take that back.
It's so awkward.
Well, hold on. I think we have a claim to call it Essay because he's falsified memos about Essay. He hasn't essayed somebody that we know about, but he's falsified memos about Essay.
Right.
So that's in the realm. Dude, can you guys believe what a scumbag this Ryan Kavanaugh is? Like, what? The record states that 2 weeks before trial, Relativity magically discovered another 2,000 documents that had previously not been produced. One of them was this HR memo that was apparently written by Genius, the HR person who had never heard of it. The document was a several-page memorandum which purported to document a pattern of egregious misconduct by Mr. Fields, none of which, strangely, was mentioned in his termination letter. An attempt to explain why the memorandum had not been produced earlier, Relativity submitted false declarations from Mr. Kavanaugh. Mr. Kavanaugh claimed in his declaration that he was the one to ferret out the location of the memorandum. In particular, he declared under oath that he suspected that documents had not been produced because it was in a private folder belonging to Miss Genius, who was no longer employed at Relativity after being given special access to Mrs. Genius' supposed private folders. He lied under oath.
A big lie.
That's crazy. So this guy should be in jail. I don't know why you can just lie under oath and just be like, cool, bye.
Yeah, and about something so serious. He ruined this guy's life. Like, he cannot...
Well, he tried.
Well, no, he for like a year, he almost couldn't get work in Hollywood.
Oh, you read that?
I read that. It was hard for him to find any work because he was accused of such a horrible act.
You know, and this coincided with the Harvey Weinstein stuff right in the midst of Me Too. So Ryan Kavanaugh is a man willing to weaponize Me Too, an essay, such a serious topic, literally just to save him money from having to pay this guy his contractual severance. I mean, there is not a bigger scumbag on this planet than Ryan Kavanaugh. Also, he's quite dumb too, if I can say that. He's actually quite dumb. He said, last edited, Cav Cav. Like, the judge is like, you are an idiot. And you trust this guy to run Triller? I mean, no wonder Triller's going bankrupt.
Yo, Triller, my thing.
No wonder their
flipped.
Thing is flipped. No. Yeah. Yeah, he wanted to ruin this guy just to save a few bucks. That's crazy. I mean, basically, falsely accusing someone of Me Too stuff is basically like false R-word accusations, which is like just the most horrible thing you can do. It's crazy, man. So disturbing. This guy wanted to come on our show, by the way. Cav Cav. Field says in bankruptcy crediting creditor document, at the first sight of this memo, he knew it was fake. That's the HR person. Janice, the HR person, was then brought in to an evidentiary hearing to testify and was asked about the memo, which claims that three unnamed female employees said that Fields had inappropriately propositioned them or touched them, that one of those unnamed female employees said Fields suggested that he could further her career. She said she thought it meant in exchange for sex, and two other unnamed female employees then led to the internal investigation to two more females, also unnamed, seven in all. So Kavanaugh has imagined a story where this guy is propositioning people for sexual favors in turn for furthering their career. These allegations, in a filing on May 29th, states these allegations were all fabrications, seemingly ripped from the headlines of then-recent Harvey Weinstein scandal. Crazy.
You're a lying dog-faced pony soldier.
Asked if there were three confirmed incidents of harassment of female employees by Fields, the HR lady said, absolutely not. There were no female employees that I was ever aware of. Asked whether a female employee talked about his ability to increase her career path, which she understood in exchange for sex, Jenna said, I am sorry, I never heard that. I mean, it's unbelievable. And then the HR woman went further to say, I have to say, I take sexual harassment extremely seriously. And the fact that all of this is attributed to me is very offensive to me. Honestly, it is very offensive to me that this is stated here when it did not occur. In fact, she said she was out sick the day the memo was supposedly written by her. Here's when it gets great. The judge wrote, and I quote, let me zoom in. I quote the judge. In conclusion, the evidence was overwhelming and undeniable that Relativity falsified the Genis memorandum. First, the metadata refuted all of Relativity's theories linking the memorandum to Genis and established that it was last modified on October 15th by Cav, which must be Kavanaugh. In fact, the metadata revealed that the hot issue folder where Kavanaugh said he found the memorandum contained other documents that suspiciously indicated someone was modifying documents in the folder after Genis left Relativity. Second, Genis credibility, credibly testified that she did not write or edit this.
It's credibility.
Well, it doesn't make... Genis credibility testified. But that's, the tense doesn't make sense.
I'm assuming it's a type of testimony as to the credibility of somebody.
Second, Genis credibility testified. Yeah, let's move on. Her critique of the memorandum style and format rang true for a lawyer with prior large firm experience. The most peculiar aspect of the memorandum was its repeated reference to Kavanaugh as co-CEO. Why would she add that reference in a memo to her own file? He's writing, he's stroking his own ego in this falsified document. Do you understand how psychotic that is? It would be silly for her to do so, she said. Finally, or that was what the judge said. Finally, had Genis been aware of sexual harassment allegations against Fields, she surely would have included that in Fields' termination letter. By falsifying the document to manufacture evidence that it had cause to terminate Fields, Relativity admitted that it otherwise lacked cause. The most appropriate sanction for such outrageous conduct is an issue sanction confirming what the falsification revealed, namely that the Relativity terminated Fields without cause. So anyway, he won $8.4 million. And so now you start to understand why this shithole went bankrupt.
Wow.
Oh, let me
You're right,
this.
Though. I mean, trying to pull that and thinking that, I mean, it sounds like it really didn't take some serious detective work to uncover that this
basic
was...
basic forensics.
Yeah.
Also, the HR lady was like, I didn't write that.
Right.
But the damage was done to the guy's reputation, like you said, AB.
Right. That's crazy.
So, you know, let me read their statement because they get mad when I don't. So here's what they had to say. Here's what Kavanaugh had to say. Had Fields won anything but a single count of breach of contract against Relativity, where an appeal would have been more costly than anything Fields may yet be paid, Relativity would have appealed. I don't know what that means. That's all you have to say?
It means they're saying it wasn't worth it for them to appeal. They're saying that we're not appealing, and the reason we're not appealing is because it's just cheaper for us to just pay him off.
Okay, so I find it interesting that in their statement, they do not address the claim by the judge that Ryan Kavanaugh falsified a fake Me Too document for a fake cause to fire someone. That is fucking bottom barrel shit. Shame on you. You or you? Which one's him? Is this him? It's the other guy. That's Ryan Kavanaugh. Shame on you, you piece of shit scumbag. Dog shit of the earth. Who does that? You, man. You, sir, are sick. Unforgivable. Sick? Go
this
ahead, Zach.
Is sick?
Thank you. Honestly, it's one of the worst things I've ever heard. It's one of the worst things a human can do, especially during that Me Too shit. I'm blown away.
You're weaponizing it. It's horrible.
blown away. Well, also, it trivializes the real accounts.
Exactly.
Because this guy's like, oh, it shows he doesn't really care because he's like, oh, look at all these valid claims. I can just sneak one in. But when you start faking shit, then everybody questions the validity of all the other shit. Like, you're muddying the water, dude. You are. He must be a sociopath.
It's funny, I'm looking through the comments on this article, which all the comments are from 2018 when the article was published. And it seems like, you know, within the industry, it was pretty well known that this guy was a giant piece of shit because it's just everybody just piling on.
Well, here's one that says, I'm totally team Kavanaugh and this judge is an idiot, written by Cav.
Here's one. Ryan Kavanaugh. This is anonymous. Ryan Kavanaugh is unhinged, unfeeling, predatory psychopath for doing this. Shame on him for hijacking the Me Too movement and spitting in the face of every woman who has ever experienced sexual harassment and or abuse.
And he, and by the way, he's still out there on Twitter, on Instagram, acting like he's the new Dana White, acting like Triller's all good. He's tagging TikTok stars. People need to tell he's tagging TikTok stars. And being like, back me up on this Ethan guy. People need to know that this is who he is. What Kavanaugh did to Adam Fields was egregious and cannot be allowed in civil society. He should be prosecuted for defrauding and defaming Fields in order to avoid his responsibilities. This must not be ignored by the media, otherwise it will send the wrong message to our society that this type of behavior is tolerated. Weaponizing the Me Too movement in this way hurts a lot of innocent people, as we can see here. This ends Me Too. Exactly. Like, I'm genuinely serious that this guy is trying. He's trying to reinvent himself. He should never live this down. Ever. You know, anyone that associates with him should know what the fuck this guy does.
It is crazy that he didn't get in bigger trouble, but, I mean, I guess it's just a matter of the DA not having the time or resources to go after something like this.
Yeah.
Then it's fraud.
Oh, yeah.
It's clearly fraud.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Yeah.
That's not fraud.
Oh, it's not?
I would call that false advertising.
Thank you, Ja Rule. And by the way, I'm not a lawyer, and in no way is that a statement of fact. No. I'm just some dude on a podcast. But in the opinion of some dude on a podcast, that's fraud.
Yeah, and so he's out there trying to raise money for Triller. But the thing that really bothers me is that people don't know about this. For some reason, this really went under the rug. And, like, again, everybody who's rubbing shoulders with him needs to know that this guy basically single-handedly killed the Me Too movement. Fucking unbelievable.
Wow.
And dumb. Just dumb. Anyway. I was shocked. I don't know if you guys find that interesting. I was absolutely shocked by that.
Yeah, I mean,
that is top tier shit.
I mean, just the level of buffoonery and, like, you know, trying to pull that off and just immediately getting caught is so embarrassing. Like, how do you even show your face after that?
Oh, one other thing before we move on. You know how they updated it on the App Store to say that...
iOS, yeah.
Yeah, they removed Kevin Hart, which is good because they listened to our feedback. But I actually have more feedback for you guys because you didn't actually update the...
The Android store.
So I have more feedback for you guys because here it says, Kevin fucking Hart, who doesn't even have an account on your website. You are a liar, sir, and this may be fraud, but I'm not a lawyer to make that determination.
It's so awkward.
So this is the man that's suing me. They even have a typo in their they have a typo here. Charlie D/Emilio. Dude, this is the man who's trying to go public and raise money. He can't even do a fucking app description without typos in it. Here, The Weeknd. Doesn't The Weeknd, he doesn't spell it like that.
He does.
Oh, okay. I stand corrected. I thought it was just The Weeknd. Yeah, so Kevin Hart is not on the app, and that's why I'm going to be giving it a 1-star from, you know, my second phone. I have a second phone. I'm going to give it a 1-star because this... But, like, they have a 3.5 here, so that's pretty interesting.
Ugh, it's so awkward.
Slow, cheap chop, cheap TikTok clone, one of the worst apps I've ever used, laggy, clunky. Yep, sounds about right.
Wait, what was that last one? Scroll back down. Scroll back down to the last one.
Oh, shit. Also, I hear bad things about the owner, Ryan Kavanaugh. I just heard a lot of bad things about him. Like how he's been accused by his ex-partner of running a Ponzi scheme. You know, now that we've, what we just learned, that's not even close to the worst thing I know about him.
It's really not.
I would say, if I were to rewrite this review, I would say, Ryan Kavanaugh falsified Me Too documents.
And what's interesting about that one is that's not an allegation. That's actually been proven in court.
That's what the judge said.
Right.
Like, I was reading what the judge said verbatim, and their response didn't even refute it, which is what's interesting.
They were like, it's not worth it to appeal.
They're like, yeah, you got us. You know, also is trigger happy when it comes to suing people, which is just bad business and a bad look. Yep, I couldn't agree more. Couldn't agree more. Oh, this one has 126 likes, so people thought that was useful. Yeah, if I were to write a review today, I would probably mention something about him falsifying fake sexual assault documents and using Me Too to further his financial interests. Pretty scummy. Look at this and tell me there's no such thing as a coincidence.
What am I looking at here?
This is, yeah, exactly. Half Ryan Kavanaugh, half Harvey Weinstein. And you tell me they do not look freaking like brothers.
There's no such thing as a coincidence.
Are you kidding me, you guys? Tell me they don't look like brothers. Hello? Someone want to back me up, Dan? You're the one that's saying he doesn't look like him.
Yeah, I still don't see it.
It looks like the same person aged a couple years.
It's fucking uncanny.
You don't see it?
How do you not see that, Dan?
That's like, dude.
It's fucking uncanny.
It's uncanny. It's uncanny. And, well, here, let me further the agenda even a little bit more. So, he says he doesn't know, he doesn't associate with Harvey Weinstein. Well, then why are you kissing his head, sir? That's Ryan Kavanaugh kissing Harvey Weinstein. Mwah. We love you, Daddy.
There's no such thing as a coincidence.
Mwah. This is him kissing his head and then plotting to use his allegations as weapons against people in his own firm. Thank you, Daddy. Now I can fire my president. Here he is.
Daddy.
Wow. Look at him. Who's that on his left? Who's this?
Is that his dad or?
That's Harvey brother? Weinstein.
Oh, Harvey.
Yeah, no, that's not his dad.
Not his dad.
Okay. Wake up.
They look like they could be family.
Spot Harvey Weinstein and spot Ryan Kavanaugh. Go. Here's the game.
I can't tell the difference.
I think this is Ryan. Yeah.
I think that's Ryan just because the hair on Harvey.
Red hair.
Yeah, yeah.
So, okay. That's my spiel for today. I thought you guys would find that interesting. You know, this is what I'm up against. A man who will do anything